Hi everyone, in this video we will be discussing the concept hedonic pricing. So this particular topic, hedonic pricing, comes under the environmental economics module of NDA NET syllabus. So if you check the previous year question papers of NET economics, you can see a few questions from this particular concept. So there are good chance that more questions may be asked in the future from this particular topic. So we'll see this topic in detail. So after discussing this particular concept, we will see few previous year questions from this particular topic. So we'll move on to the topic. So hedonic pricing. So the hedonic pricing method is used to estimate economic value for ecosystem or environmental services that directly affect market prices. So in simple terms, this particular method, hedonic pricing, is used to value or assess the value of surroundings or environmental factors that may directly affect market prices. So using this method, the value of any commodity or a property or anything is calculated also by considering the value of environment or the surroundings. So that is what hedonic pricing basically means, or that is how pricing is done using hedonic pricing. The external factors or the surroundings, the value of surroundings of the ecosystem or environment, is also involved in the pricing strategy. Based on the premise that price is determined by both internal characteristics of the good being sold and external factors affecting it. So let's take the case of a property or a house. So in that particular situation, it is not just the value of house it is considered, but also the value of surroundings is considered. So if it is a good surrounding, serene surrounding, then the value will also increase. But if it is not so pleasant or if it is a timid atmosphere or a surrounding, then the value will come down. So whenever value of something, especially housing especially house property, is considered, the value of environmental situation or surroundings will also be added. So by adding that, not only the internal factors are added into pricing method, but also the external factors. So using hedonic pricing, the value of surroundings or the environment or the ecosystem is considered in market price. So hedonic pricing identifies the factors and characteristics that affect an item's price. So this is not only just about that particular item, but also about the factors and the surroundings that affect that particular item's price. So hedonic pricing is most often seen in housing market. So this type of pricing method is more often seen in this case of housing. It is often seen in the case of housing, because whenever somebody is trying to buy a house, they also consider the surroundings or the environment. So is it in the city, or is it in outskirts, or is there any serene value to the environment? Is it beautiful environment? All such factors come into matter, and that definitely directly affects the market price. So because of the surrounding does matters in the case of housing prices, this particular method is often found in house markets, where houses and other properties are sold. So this is quite often seen in housing market. So it is most commonly applied to variations in housing prices. So this may be a reason, like changes in the environmental value may be a reason for changes in house prices. So that is also considered when hedonic pricing is considered. So the variation in house prices, one house may be priced higher than the other house. One of the reason may be the environment, the serene value, or based on the locality, or whether it is situated in a city area or an outskirts area. So all such factors comes into matter when it comes to hedonic prices. Since all such environmental factors are coming into act, this particular type of pricing method is often seen in housing market. Now, it can be used to estimate economic benefits or cost associated with environmental quality, including air pollution, water pollution, or noise. So when we say hedonic pricing, all these kind of things, all the things which are connected to environment will come into the picture. So whether the environment is polluted, whether good air is available or good water is available, all things comes into matter when we say hedonic pricing. So environmental amenities such as aesthetic views or proximity to recreational sites. So all these factors, as I said earlier, based on the locality, based on the serene beauty of a place, the price also changes. If it is at a beautiful location, calm and quiet location, then definitely house prices will be higher than the other kind of unpleasant places. So now we will move on to previous year questions. So basically what we have to remember when we say hedonic pricing is that hedonic pricing assess the value of environment and the ecosystem or the surroundings, and it is quite often seen in the case of housing market. So environment and ecosystem is given a particular value in the case of hedonic pricing. Now we will see the questions. So this question was asked in June 2019 NDA net economics exam. The question is, the hedonic price method measures the value of environmental assets through. So option A, using existence of an environmental asset. Option B, using linkages between variations of in-house prices. Using WTP to value of environmental assets. Using WTA value of environmental assets. So we have just seen that this particular method, hedonic pricing method, is often seen in housing market, and this method is used to see in-house price variation, the variation in house prices. So that's how hedonic prices works in housing market. Since this is quite often used in housing market, and it considers the value of external factors like environment, option B is the correct answer here. So option B says that using linkages between variations of in-house prices, which means that variation, it uses the variations in house prices, and that variation is created by external factors like ecosystem and environment. So here in this question, correct answer is option B. Now we will move on to next question. This question was asked in the year July 2018 July. So the question is, which of the following is often referred to as the hedonic price method for valuing environmental asset? So the first option, using linkages between variations in in-house prices and geographical proximity to an environmental asset. That is the first option, which is absolutely correct. Now second option, using existence value to estimate the value of environmental asset, which is not correct. Option 3, using travel cost to estimate the value of an environmental asset, which is also not correct. Option 4, using willingness to pay to value an environmental asset, which is partially correct but not entirely correct. So here we know that we have just seen when we learned the concept that hedonic price method using linkages between variations in in-house prices. So here in this question, option is right answer is option 1, which is using linkages between variations in in-house prices and geographical proximity to an environmental asset, and this is the correct method for assessing hedonic price. So option is correct answer is option 1. Now we will move on to next question. This question was asked in the year 2014 in paper 3. So the question is, which of the following method would be used for estimation of price change of a house due to either pollution or good environment like existence of park and scenic beauty. We have seen that in-house price variation is determined by hedonic price method. So correct answer is hedonic price method. So here in this question, correct answer is option A. So that is the few questions we have discussed. That were the few questions we have seen in previous year questions. So the main thing you have to remember here in the case of hedonic pricing is that hedonic pricing basically considers the external factors, which basically means that the environment and the surroundings, and it is often connected with in-house price variation or in the case of housing market. So I hope all of you have understood. Thank you.